Hi, welcome to my movie review. Today's movie is Bad Boys with Martin Lawrence and Will Smith. Surprised Will Smith's name doesn't come first there. Maybe it's alphabetical order. What you gonna do, Bad Boys? Bad Boys is a film. The title actually reminds me of an article that Don sent me the other day. Thanks very much, Don, for sending me this. This is a the kind of thing that if you're a parent of a boy, could make your blood boil. But let's see if we can find some humor in it rather than getting angry, because these people are really just worth laughing at this point. Let's see here. Outrage as young boys are forced to stand in school assembly and apologize for rapes committed by their gender to female classmates. A school has sparked outrage by forcing its young male students to apologize on behalf of their gender to female classmates. Brower College in the southwestern Victorian town of Warrnambool, which is in Australia, held an assembly on Wednesday where boys were told to stand up in a symbolic gesture of apology to girls and women. One parent said her son in year 7 was left confused about why he had to stage the bizarre apology, where boys were told to say sorry that women are raped and sexually assaulted. Oh, my God, man. See, this is about teaching boys to respect females. It's not teaching pupils to respect everyone, or at least give everyone a very base level of respect and let them earn or lose from that point on. No, it's about respecting girls and women only. Almost as if one of two things, right? One, either males in general are already ultra respected, and therefore they don't need to be taught to respect them, or because women like automatically respect males, and I think we all know that that's fucking bullshit because they clearly don't. Or it's saying that they're not boys are not worthy of respect, therefore we don't need to teach girls to respect men because they're not worthy of respect. I think we know which one it is, I think we know which one it is. And this is the kind of thing as well that if you know boys, I happen to have, for those who don't know, I happen to have a young boy, he's 12 now. If he was taught this in his school, I would punch the headmaster right in the fucking face, and I would let him know exactly why he got that. And I would gladly wait there for the police to arrive, because at least I would then know that he's learned that you can't treat people's boys like that without some sort of consequence. It is fucking disgusting to teach boys as rapists. I mean, one guy rapes somebody, the boys are held responsible. So should we get the girls to stand up and apologize to the boys for all the women who've made false allegations, for all the women who aborted men's babies without them knowing they were doing it? Should that happen? Of course it shouldn't happen, because that's not them that did it. It's like we're losing this idea that people are individuals who, some people do bad things, some don't. To put it all down to one group, and as I always say, as everybody always says, imagine doing this with blacks. Imagine all the blacks had to stand up in the class and apologize to the whites for the level of crime. It would be fucking disgusting. Fucking disgusting. That's what it would be. I mean, just the other day, I think it was Bradford. Pretty sure it was Bradford. Anyway, in England, a teacher apparently showed a picture of a cartoon Muhammad. The next thing you know, for the next few days, there's a mass fucking protest outside the school. One side has got the non-Muslims who say should be allowed free speech. The other side has got the Muslims desperate to, do what they do, demanding the teacher be fired. This is because this one teacher apparently showed a cartoon depiction of Muhammad, right? I don't want to get into that right now. I just don't care, right? But the point is that there are no crowds outside this school. There are no crowds outside this school demanding that fucking teacher gets fired for what they did, because what they did is absolutely fucking reprehensible. Anyway, here's a screenshot here. It says, Brower is the most fucked up school you can go to. If this offends anyone, I do not care. I personally will stand by this till I die. Guys go through as much shit as girls do, even if it's mainly girls. I do not care. Well said. I mean, let's read this article. He said that he was made to stand up and basically apologise. It wasn't explained properly to the male students what they were doing or why they were doing it, the mother, Danielle Shepherd, told 7 News. They've even got a poll here. Look, should male students have to apologise for their gender's behaviour in school assemblies? Of course they fucking shouldn't. Each individual should apologise if that individual feels sorry and that they've, you know, they've done something wrong. They shouldn't. Nobody should ever be forced to apologise, because a forced apology is not an apology. But nobody should ever be forced to apologise. But if somebody wants to apologise, that's up to the individual. I can't. If the guy who lives in the next close, who is also a white male, therefore looks kind of like me a wee bit, if he goes out and stabs somebody or steals a car, that's none of my fucking business. I can't apologise for him. I don't know him. I don't give two shits about him. Why should I apologise for it? So if I don't apologise for him, why should boys apologise for things that men that they don't know have done? It's sick. It's fucking sick. Really sick. They really should have made more of an effort to notify the parents. No, they didn't want to notify the parents, because a lot of these parents might be very upset that their son has been treated like he's basically a rapist, because another guy somewhere is a rapist. In a separate post on Facebook, Ms. Shepherd shared another complaint from a parent who called the assembly a joke. Wow, just wow. It's a woman then. This is actually disgusting, Brower College. Not at all impressed that you made my son apologise for something he's never done nor considered doing, she wrote. A male student also criticised the assembly in a Snapchat post. Can I just say as well, you know, fucking, I know for a fact that, I don't know if it will be in this article, I haven't read the whole article, but I know for a fact that see when those boys were forced to apologise for something that they did not do, right? I fucking guarantee you that 99% of the girls and 99% of the mothers that don't have sons fucking love that shit. They love that shit. They love to force men to grovel, you know? And yet, funnily enough, they don't respect men who do it. They just want to see if they can force them to do it, you know? Fucking, I bet the girls were sat in that assembly with a fucking big smug fucking grin on their face, knowing that these boys were going through that. I bet not fucking one of them dared to stand up and say, wait a minute here, why are they getting treated like this? They've not mistreated us. What the fuck? No, none of them would have, because girls, they're conformists, they go along with everything, you know, they're not going to stand up. Today at Brower, they made every guy stand up and apologise to every girl for rape, sexual assault, the student said. Guys go through as much shit as girls do. Brower College Principal Jane Boyle, is anybody surprised that it's a woman, said the apology part of the assembly was inappropriate but defended the school's intentions. The assembly included the screening of a video message by Brisbane Boys College Captain Mason Black about being proactive in stopping incidents of sexual assault and harassment, she said in a statement. But boys would do that though. You don't need to teach them that. As part of this discussion, I bet what they're actually trying to do is they're trying to get boys to browbeat their friends when their friends tell a joke about women, because you're only allowed to tell jokes about white heterosexual males. So if you tell a joke about women, it obviously leads to rape. I don't know how many times I've heard a joke about women and immediately went out and raped a woman, because it's just what happens. As part of this discussion, boys were asked to stand as a symbolic gesture of apology for the behaviours of their gender that have hurt or offended girls and women. What would have happened if the boys didn't? What would have happened if one of the boys says, I'm not standing up, no, I'm not doing that? I bet you they'd get punished for that. I mean, what the fuck? The behaviours of their gender, right? So, okay, so that means girls must apologise for all the women that have falsely accused men of rape. It's only fair. It's only fair. After all, if even one woman does it, they're all guilty. In retrospect, while well-intended, no, it's not well-intended at all. It's fucking vile. How can you even suggest this is well-intended? Hey, why don't we class all the males in the school as fucking rapists and get them to apologise for it? At what point did you think that was well-intentioned? Or well-intended, whatever. We recognise that this part of the assembly was inappropriate, and you recognise it now because you've been called out on it. How could you not recognise it until you were called out on it? What the fuck? It's like beating a fucking old woman in the face, and somebody says, you know, you shouldn't do that, that's an old woman, and then you go, oh my god, I didn't even realise that that was wrong until somebody pointed it out. There was me punching her, beating an old woman senseless, and I didn't even know that it was wrong until somebody else mentioned it. That's how fucking stupid these people are. Fuck. One mother said on Facebook, their son had told her the exercise was simply intended to raise awareness. I raise awareness that your son's a rapist. By default. My son explained they stood not to apologise but to stand in support and solidarity. Another parent wrote, okay, and are you okay with your son being singled out like that? And not everybody, why can't everybody stand up and do that then? I mean, with the amount of fucking teachers raping students, you would think that the girls should stand up, you know? Maybe they should stand up and apologise, oh sorry, show solidarity. Fuck off, man. You'll find all schools will be teaching consent over the next year. Brower won't be the only one. Teaching consent. Because if a rapist was taught consent in school, he wouldn't be a rapist. Or rather, she wouldn't be a rapist, right? Okay. Let's teach women, or let's teach girls, not to become teachers who take advantage of their male students. Why don't we do that? Because that happens all the time. Why don't we do that?
Oh, where was she when I was in school?
Fucking punch these guys, man. Anyway, the assembly came just days after Wesley College in Melbourne was hit with claims. Some of its male students were ranking female students based on their looks. Yes, I absolutely fucking guarantee that the girls do the exact same thing with the boys. The exact same thing. But do you know what's worse? Do you know why the girls are even worse? Because the boys, they're rating the girls and they're going, she's a 10, she's a 9 or whatever, right? Oh, it's Australia, sorry. I meant, she's a 6, she's a 5. That was a joke, okay? Calm down, Aussies. Calm down. It's just a joke. No, but that's what the boys do, right? And the girls, they also do that. They look at the boys and they say, he's a 10, he's a 9 or whatever, right? But what makes the girls even worse is the girls look at the girls and say, she's a 2, she's a 1, she's fucking fat, she's fucking this, she's fucking that. So don't give me that crap that the boys are bad for judging the girls on their looks, because that's all the boys are doing. The boys aren't turning on each other and going, look at him, let's talk behind his back. You know, let's spread a vicious, vile fucking rumour about him. Let's do that. Boys don't do that shit. Girls, on the other hand, as many people have pointed out, if they could choose, who would you rather be bullied by in school? The girls or the boys? 9 times out of 10, people are going to say the boys. And the 1 time out of 10 is somebody who doesn't know anything about girls. It's far easier to get bullied off a boy because it's physical. It's, you know, it's a beating. It doesn't last a lifetime and you can fight back fairly. Girls with a gossip, vicious rumours and shit like that, you know, they tear you down behind your back before you've even known you've been torn down, you know. Girls are fucking vicious, but we can't talk about that because we must respect girls because they're totally worthy of total respect because they never do anything bad. No. And they certainly never judge boys on their looks. Girls judge boys on their looks. Don't be silly. Only boys do that. Multiple harassment and assault allegations have been levelled by students at the school. By male students, female students, what? Victorian Acting Premier James Merlino has since moved to make teaching consent compulsory in all government schools from next month. God. I mean, again, they think this is well intended. This is a good thing. Yes, it is a good thing not to rape. But it's the fact that the focus seems to be on the boys. Not right. The initiative previously did not explicitly direct schools to teach consent and instead focused on relationships, sexuality and safety. From term two, the directive will compel state schools to teach the government's respectful relationships training on free agreements. I'd like to see that, actually. I'd like to see what that looks like. Mr. Merlino said Victoria and other states should not be complacent on ensuring consent was taught well in classrooms. Respectful relationships is proven to make a real difference and is a recommendation of the Royal Commission into Family Violence. What? The Education Minister said in a statement on Sunday, it is a programme that should be rolled out nationwide, but we have to listen to students who say they want and need a greater focus on this issue in the classroom. See, this is my concern, right? Imagine your child coming home, right? Your son, right? And you say to them, so what's 2 plus 2? What does that mean? 2 plus 2, what is it? I don't know what that means. All I know is that I must respect women and girls. And I am sorry for all the rape that has happened in the world, even though I didn't do it, you know. What are they at school for? I mean, but again, no crowds outside that school. Show a cartoon of Muhammad. There's crowds outside the school for a week. Probably more than that. And that teacher will get fired, by the way, or he'll get moved on. It is why we will mandate the teaching of consent in all government schools in an age-appropriate way. Mason Black stood in front of his peers last Thursday and told them he feels sick about the claims of sexual assault and that the narrative needs to change. It makes me feel sick and it makes me feel embarrassed that our school is featured in the testimonies of young women who are victims of sexual assault. Well, alleged victims, let's be honest, they lie about that a lot. So, oh no, I can't mention that, sorry, because they're totally worthy of respect and would never do that. Sorry, my bad. Brisbane Boys College is another of several schools in Australia that has been named in testimonies from private and public school girls who say they were either sexually assaulted, harassed or raped. I don't believe them. Mr. Black said, I don't know who these are, let's see. Consent should be included in sexuality education earlier. Sign the petition. Oh God. Thousands of schoolgirls shared their experiences after Kambala School alumni Chanel Contos 22 launched a petition demanding students be taught about consent. Mr. Black, so she doesn't have a boyfriend and she hates men because of it. Okay, so she wants to speak ill about men. Okay, we get it, sweetheart, we get it. Fuck's sake, you just need a dick. Mr. Black said his mother had been sexually abused when she was a little girl and later told Channel 7 Sunrise he only found out by searching her name on Google. My own mother, at the age of 10, against her will, was sexually abused before she learned about the birds and the bees, he said. Right, what's this got to do with the kids at your school? Sorry, I'm confused. Why should the boys at your school be treated like shit because of what happened to your mother when she was 10? I'm sorry, I don't understand the connection. Are you brave enough to ask your mum about her experiences? He said. What about your sister's friends? You shouldn't have to ask women these questions. No, I'm sorry, but you don't do that. You don't come home from school. Most kids come home from school. What's for dinner? You know, either watch TV, or sorry, that's the old days, go on the laptop or whatever. They don't come home and say, so, mum, were you raped when you were younger? What's going on? Yeah, that doesn't... What the fuck are you trying to do to these kids? What the fuck are you doing here? You lost your fucking mind. But this is the apology. In retrospect, while well-intended, we recognise this part of the assembly was inappropriate. Let's see. Schools play an important role, blah, blah, blah. This week, the whole school assembly discussed the topic of respect for women, not respect for people in general. You see, it's already biased. We're not talking about respect for people, respect for women. Oh, and the importance of bystander behaviour and speaking up to report incidents of inappropriate behaviour. So don't dare tell a joke about girls, fuck's sake. The assembly included the screening of a video. I told us that as part of this discussion, boys were asked to stand as a symbolic gesture of apology for the behaviours of their gender that have hurt or offended girls and women. Fucking disgusting. I still can't believe they said while well-intended. At what part of that there? How How smooth does your brain have to be to think anything in this part here is well intended? It's just, and if nobody said anything about it, they probably kept doing it. Tell you, man, somebody has to get hurt for this badly, and that bitch or that fucking asshole that did it needs to lose the fucking job. That's disgusting, treating kids like that. Any kids. Crikey, that is not right at all. In front of everyone, you're dictating and degrading the boys at all levels. This is unacceptable. Absolutely not on. Blanket apologies do not do anything but appease virtue signals. This is a thing as well. It's not a real apology. Do you really? Here's the thing. These boys are not going to feel sorry and apologetic for what happens to women and girls. They're not. They're actually going to resent women and girls. And maybe that's the plan, I don't know. But that's what's going to happen, because they're going to go home and they're going to think to themselves, wait a minute, I was forced to stand up, be treated like a rapist. Why again? Oh, because of women. Fuck them. How dare they treat me like that? That's what they're going to think. And that's what the black students would think if they were forced to do it to white people. They would go home and they'd think, wait a minute, I was forced to... I was embarrassed and forced to stand up and apologise for what other black criminals did that aren't me. What the fuck? For what was the reason again? Because of white people? Fuck those crackers. That's what they're going to think. These boys are just going to resent females. They're not going to respect them. When you try to force anybody to respect anybody, they're only going to resent them. They're not going to respect them. It's just not, it's not going to happen, and it's stupid, but again, maybe that's secretly the plan, you know? Educated stupidity. Why should someone, male or female, apologise for something they have not done? We are not EU law or policy, so sack the headmistress principal or the so-called educated stupidity. So wrong on so many levels. Boys ranking girls on their looks, oh my god, said no one ever. I know. And girls ranking boys, oh no, that doesn't happen. I know, it's such, I've mentioned this many, many times, right? One of the biggest things I fucking hate in life, right? Especially this millennium, right? Because it wasn't really the case last millennium. But this millennium is this fucking bullshit where we have to play the pretend game. We have to pretend, you know, the only boys are doing this. Those evil boys are judging girls on their looks. Yes, we know that, but at least be honest and admit that girls do it too. We know girls do it too, you know? Stop pretending. Stop this bullshit. And by the way, when am I getting my apology from all women for them judging my looks when I was in school? Yes, they said I was a 10, but that's not the point. That's not the point. Point is, they still judged my looks, and I want an apology from all women that didn't take part in that. They owe me an apology. Fucking hell. Stupid pretend bullshit, man. Total BS. Parents need to quit being sheep and stand up to crap like this. Yes, they do. Because this is the thing. My son comes home and tells me this, I'm going to cause a massive stink about this. You're fucking right, I'm going to the school. You're fucking right, I want to speak to the fucking teacher that did this and give her a fucking good old earful. You're fucking right, I want to speak to the headmaster. And you're fucking right, I want that bitch punished for what she did to my son. Fucking right, I'm going to sit here and not do anything. But that's... And I imagine, where I'm from here, I don't think that'll go down well. Because lots of parents, including the women, by the way, they would be up there fucking starting a war over that shit. No fucking way would they stand for that. The feminist agenda is making my blood boil these days. This is all about demonizing men. Why don't we talk about how damaging women can be? Whoa, come on now. Women don't cause damage. They are 100% worthy of respect. How dare you suggest that they could ever do anything wrong? They are perfect. In fact, they are more than perfect. Pure witches that are bad at friendships most of the time. If you're in a girlfriend circle, I bet my bottom dollar someone in that group has made a remark about you behind your back. Absolutely guarantee it. Real women don't want this. I've raised my son right, and he is extremely respectful of all people. Notice you said all people and not women. I'd be horrified if my son is put through this. The wokest school. Why does the left feel that to lift one group they must demonise another? They seem to think that, don't they? These are kids, they are innocent. If they want to send a message, then increase jail time for offenders. Stop giving them slaps on the wrist. Okay, BS lonely left propaganda, a disease that needs to be destroyed. Absolutely crazy. Because the thing is, as well, as I said, there's a lot of women that would agree with this. You know, secretly with a smug little fucking grin, you know.
Mm-hmm, that's right. Get those boys to, you know, take the knee. Oh, sorry, that's another group. Get those boys to apologise for, you know, for something they didn't do.
Fucking, they love that shit, man. That's why you should never apologise. That's why you should never put your fist up. That's why you should never take the knee. That's why you should never stand in solidarity. Fuck them all. Apology not accepted. You knew what you were doing. If I had a son there, he'd be pulled out immediately. Sick. The problem does not stem from this age group. The re-education is needed in the grandfathers, whose treatment of females has been seen and accepted by grandmothers, sons and daughters, and then subsequently grandchildren. Yes, because obviously the grandmothers didn't do anything wrong ever at any point in their lives. The older generation need to know that women are not possessions at the... Oh my God. Have you seen women on social media? I mean, they do, right, pretty much all the time is objectify themselves. Pretty much all the time. But no, they're not possessions. Okay. And like the hottest women make it very, very clear that they're only interested in men with money who can buy them, let's be honest. But no, they're not possessions. Again, we need to play the pretend game here. We don't see those women doing these things. We've never seen this before, and we need to pretend we've never seen it, you know, because we must respect women, and grandfathers are evil or some pish. Well, the girls we made to stand and apologise for their gender, who have made false... Oh, thank you. Who have made false allegations against males. I haven't seen these comments, I swear, but that's exactly what my thought was as well. And naming these names, to name a few, these are probably false accusers. There is a line that the woke movement just crossed. I apologise to nobody for anything unless I am personally wrong. That's exactly it, isn't it? That's exactly it. And even then, you shouldn't be forced to do it. This is a disgrace. This head teacher must be sacked. Absolutely. Look, if a guy, and he will, if a guy is going to get sacked, and he will, for showing a cartoon depiction of Muhammad, if he has to be sacked or, as I said, moved on, then the head teacher here who is in charge absolutely must be fired, or the teacher who made them do that must be fired. Because believe me, as I said before, if that teacher made the black student stand up, or what would it be in Australia, the Aboriginal students, whatever, the black students, right, to apologise and stand in solidarity to show that you're sorry for all the crimes committed against whites, that teacher would be fired. That teacher would be fired already. Schools need to stop using students as political puppets. Parents need to teach their children, girls and boys, the difference between what is right and wrong. Respect towards others, manners and all other things parents teach their children before they're sent to school. Then the school's job is to educate them on things parents can't teach. Pretty much. So the world has gone mad. Stay home for a virus we don't have. Apologise for what you have not done. What next? Next you apologise for being white. Nah, we've already done that, I think. Why? The world's gone crazy. Not all men do that to women or men. So why make them do that? Because males are one of the groups that it's okay to mistreat. That's why there's no call to teach girls to respect males. Because males are one of the groups that it's okay to shit on, you know. White men preferably, you know, because you can shit on them all day long. So there's no demand for it the other way around, which is something I would bring up if this was my son, you know. Why are you not teaching the girls to respect my son? Why are you teaching the girls basically to shit on my son, you know, when he has to be taught to respect the girls and not the other way around? Very strange. Just because our government is run by deplorable men doesn't the future, whatever. This is pretty disturbing. These children had to apologise for something they barely understand. Just ridiculous. Disgraceful. The world has gone mad. These boys have done nothing to apologise for. Utterly ridiculous. We need classes to teach consent, not to shame our young men. Completely wrong approach, and I hope other schools learn from this mistake. No. Other schools will learn to hide the mistake better. You know, that's what the other schools will learn. Other schools will make it the case that if the boys, after they've had to apologise, mention this outside the school, it will be hate speech and they will be suspended for it.
They'll learn from, rather than say, you know what, maybe we shouldn't do this, they'll still do it, but they'll find a way to hide it. That's what they'll do. Whoever authorised this should be sacked. What a disgusting thing to do to children. Exactly, they should be. But then it would have to really affect girls before anybody's going to lose their job, or blacks, or non-whites, and non-Christians, or whatever. Anyway, sorry, I got distracted. Let me go back to my review of Bad Boys. Anyway, so Bad Boys, it's okay if you like that kind of thing, I suppose. Anyway, thank you very much for listening to my movie review. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you now go and see the movie, after this extensive review. Anyway, thank you very much. Until next time.